to Legacy IS Academy. Today I am going to discuss important topic of CSAT, that is mensuration. In the last video I covered two important topic of mensuration, that is square and rectangle. In mensuration, formulas of these topics are very very important. You have to know the basics of these formulas, only then you are going to solve the questions. Like consider one rhombus. In rhombus is nothing but, it is a type of square only, but we do not have angle between two side is 90 degree. So here area of rhombus is d1 into d2 upon 2. You have to remember, sometimes they will ask very direct questions and they will ask the area of the rhombus. They will say that the rhombus have two diagonal of length 20 and 25. Find the area of the rhombus. Simply you have to just put just use the formula and get the answer. One more important important concept, like trapezium. In trapeziums, like two parallel line, but both of these two parallel line does not have angle of 90 degree. So here you have to remember, the area of trapezium will be half of sum of parallel line into height. That is again very very important. This formula again will help you to solve a question. In case they will ask one question from trapezium, you have to use the formula and get the answer. Okay, in this one more, like we have regular hexagon. Regular hexagon is nothing but when we combine equilateral triangles, six equilateral triangles, we are going to get a hexagon. So here only thing you have to remember, the formula of hexagon, it is 3 root 3 into a square by 2. Sometimes they are asking very direct questions, you have to only know the formula. In this particular question, I will more focus about circle. In circle, you have to know basics of circle, and then we will solve some question which UPSC has asked. So first of all, area of circle, you know, all of you know, pi r square. The value of pi is 22 upon 7. These things, though, you all of you know. Second thing is, what is the circumference of circle? Circumference of circle is 2 pi r. That things you have to remember. And arc of xy, it is a theta upon 360 into 2 pi r. So these formulas you have to remember. You have to remember area is pi r square, circumference is 2 pi r, and arc, length of arc is theta upon 360 into 2 pi r. This is the basic about the circle. Let's see some questions. See this particular question. I will suggest, first of all, you have to pause the video and then try to solve it. Here we have two circle, they are joined, and in between them we have a square. Consider like that. We have a circle. This circle have radius 1 centimeter. Okay, when this is the square, this is the square, it simple mean this angle will be 90 degree. So what is the area of this entire region? Okay, so area of this entire region will be theta into 360 into pi r square. So we can say that theta is 90 in upon 360 into pi r will be 1 square. So it become pi upon 4. Okay, one thing we have got, and we know that this is our triangle. This is the triangle. Triangle base 1 and height 1. So this is the entire area. This is the entire area. And another one, area of area of rectangle or area of right angle triangle, it will be half base into height. Half base is 1 and height is also 1, then area will be 1/2. If I am able to subtract from this area to this area, I will able to get half of this shaded area. So half of the shaded area, half of the shaded area equal to pi by 4 minus 1/2. Okay, I got 1/2. This half I got. Now I have to double it. Then area of the shaded area, area of shaded area will be double of pi by 2 minus 1/2. It become pi minus pi by 2 and pi minus 1. Okay, just wait, it is pi by 4, not pi by 2, it is pi by 4. It become pi by 2. So hope you are able to understand. Only thing is you have to see the figure or the pictures very carefully and decode the pictures. So here this is the one circle. First I got the area of entire circle and then I got the area of this triangle. Then I am subtracting the area of right angle triangle from entire circle. I am getting the area of half of the shaded portions. When I am going to double it, it become area of the shaded portion. So hope you are able to understand this particular questions. So see one more questions. These questions look like very difficult, but it is very very easy questions. Here we know that circumference of circle is 2πr. 2πr. So what will be the length of it? Definitely this is the semicircle, it will be pi r. When I am telling this is r, okay, if this length is r, definitely this length will be pi r, because entire circumference is 2πr. Okay, again if this is r, this is will be r by 2 and this will be r by 2. So this circumference will be pi r by 2 and this circumference will be pi r by 2. So what is the ratio? Ratio will be pi r upon pi r by 2 plus pi r by 2. When we add, it become pi r upon pi r, means 1:1. By looking only this particular figure, you have to get an answer. All of you have to do the practice. Practice matters a lot. You know, okay, this length is pi r and this length is pi r by 2. This length is pi r by 2. When we are going to add these two values, it become pi r. So ratio will be 1:1. Hope you are able to understand this particular question. Let's see one more questions. This is again very not very difficult questions. Okay, so whenever we talked about now this question, UPSC has combined two concepts, concept of square and concept of circle. So both the concept you have to know. When I combine this line to this line, it become diagonal of the square. Okay, so length of the diagonal of the square will be 2√2. We know that length of the diagonal is 2√2a, side is a, we can say like that also, 2 square plus 2 square, it become 8 and it become 2√2. Okay, when I put here and this become radius, so radius of circle will be radius of circle will be 2√2 by 2, it become √2. Okay, so now we know that this is the radius of circle, that is √2. If in this particular questions, if I will take entire area of the circle and I am able to subtract the area of the square, remaining will be shaded area of shaded portions. So we can see that area of shaded portion equal to area of circle, area of circle minus area of square. Okay, area of circle will pi r square means root 2 square minus it become area of square, it become 2 square. Okay, so it become 2 pi minus 4. So hope you are able to understand, answers will be A. So only thing is you have to understand the figure or the picture which is giving and apply the concept. If you are able to apply the concept, you are going to get answers also. Now come to one more question. Here again you have to know the concept of square and you have to know the concept of circle. If you know both the concept, you are able to solve this question very easily. Like here in the previous questions they have put it one square inside the circle, in this question they have put it circle inside the square. Okay, so here you know that if I am doing like that, this become a circle or this become a square only. This is the square. Okay, this is the square of length 1 1 1 1. Okay, if I will get the if I will calculate the area of entire this region, so I can say that area of shaded portion equal to area of square, area of square minus area of arc means this arc, this arc. So area of square will be 1 square, area of arc will be theta upon 360 pi r means 1 square. So 1 minus theta is 90, so 90 upon 60 it become 1 upon 4 pi. So it become 1 minus pi by 4. Hope you are able to understand this particular questions also. One thing is, don't see randomly this solution. First solve yourself, first apply your mind how you will solve it. Okay, if I am solving differently, try to learn this shortcut method also. Okay, how I am solving, in that way you have to solve these particular questions. Okay, now come to one more questions. The diameter of two circular coin are in ratio 1 to 3. The smaller coin is made of roll around the bigger coin till it returns to the position from where the process of rolling started. Okay, diameter we have like one big coin, the diameter consider 3, one small coin diameter 1. So this is rotating around this particular bigger coin. How many times the smaller coin roll around the bigger coin? This is the very, if you understand the questions, if you visualize the things, this question is very very easy. How much distance a smaller coin will cover? A smaller coin will cover, distance means circumference, circumference of big coin. Okay, so circumference of big coin upon circumference of a small coin. These many circles, these many turn this small coin will take. So circumference of big coin 2 pi r. Okay, circumference of small coin 2 pi 1. So they will take 3 round. So a smaller coin will take 3 round to move around the big coin. So hope you are able to understand it. Now so here I have discussed the basic concept of circle and I gave the idea what type of questions UPSC is asking on the topic of the circle. So hope you are able to understand the basic questions UPSC is combining with the other topics also, like square with circle, rectangle with circle. So hope you are able to understand this particular topic, and in the next video I will try to cover three dimensions topic on mensuration. Thank you for watching this particular video.